Alright, good day guys, welcome again to my channel. I am Joshua the designer. So in the last few attempts I've been able to show to you how to carry out slab reinforcement detailing in a very simple step. So I'll be showing you further today how to do beam reinforcement detailing in a very simple way. Alright, so just go with me guys. So still with the same plan, I'll be showing you various types of beams and how to provide an appropriate reinforcement detailing for each of these types. So the first one we'll be doing today is planning a simply supported beam, so that we'll start from the basics and then we'll pick up from there. So a simply supported, basically, as you know, is a beam that is primarily supported that has two end supports basically. So such beam primarily would have a main reinforcement, and in some cases of doubly reinforced sections we have the compression reinforcement. So let us just get into the deal. So let's assume that only these two supports are applicable for our designs, you know, just this and this, to make it a simply supported, for instance. But beam 3 in this case is a continuous beam, all right, because it has more than one span. Obviously, I believe you understand that. So let's just take a span of this, put up this elevation, and then produce a detail for that. All right, so to do that, I want to extend my grid lines, because they're going to give me an inch to where my beam should span. All right, so, and the detail of the information of my beam, the section details of my beam are basically 450 mm by 225 mm thick beam. So I have 450 offset, all right. Then I have beams at this end also. So the first thing I'm doing now is the elevation drawing, all right. So I have to first draw an elevation, then from there we pick up on every other thing. So because we have supports for this beam, so that's why I'm trying to create something as this you see. It takes time to interpret what exactly your beam is on the plan, and it should be interpreted correctly, and that's what I'm doing now, so that you can see for yourself afterwards. Right, so I can extend this. Good, because I have slabs here also, slab in the other, or the other side of my beam, the one I'm drawing the elevation, so I have to show that while I'm doing this detail also. So I have an offset of the thickness of the slab 150. Then because the slab and this is supposed to be a monolithic construction, all right, so, and that's why I have something like this. Right, so this exactly tells what my beam looks like. All right, so this is a beam in elevation. All right, so you may call this the name, whatever it is, beam 3 A to B. All right, you can just decide to call it that name, beam 3 A to B. All right, and so we can reduce this text to something that works. All right, so beam 3 A to B. Now remember I said that beam 3 is a continuous beam. All right, I'm just bringing out this pan so that we can use it to explain what a simply supported beam looks like. All right, So do not misinterpret what I've just done. Beam 3 is a continuous beam, but in this case, I just brought out this single span to explain what a simply supported beam would look like. All right, so we have this, and like you know already that I have been bringing explanation to detailing in the standard, following the standard method of detailing. All right, so I'll be showing to you also the rules or the guidelines to doing this, so you should also pay attention just right now. All right, so this you can see on my screen now shows to you the rules that guides beam detailing. All right, but I have two of them, two of this type here. I have the simply supported type of beam here, and I also have the cantilever type of beam here. All right, so we were dealing with the simply supported here, so I'll be bringing out the information on simply supported, and I'll be explaining to you in this video. In the next video, I'll make attempts to show you how to detail the cantilever end and all other kind of beams. All right, so but for this video, let's stay with simply supported end that has a restrained end. You see that that's a restrained end. All right, so basically simply supported beam in detailing seems to be the simplest form of detailing. All right, so because you see that now there is a break point at this place where my cursor is moving over. All right, and to the left would represent all the details we need to apply on our simply supported beam. All right, so it says that the end anchorage according to 5.4.11.3 A or B of this manual should be adopted. That's for the end anchorage. Now, when you check this particular reference, you discover that it speaks of the end anchorage as either straight bars or bent bars. So you can apply the straight bar or the end bar. But which is best applicable, which is best advisable rather, is the bent bar. So I would advise you to stay with the bent bar in application. All right, so going back to drawing, you want to maintain your cover in all that you do. All right, which is 25 mm usually for beam, then maintain the thickness. You may want to change the color, then the thickness. All right, so the cover by the side also, do not forget to maintain such covers as they are essential in this detail. All right, so now I've made my top and bottom bars. All right, so I just want to create a demarcation, and that's an allowance between this anchorage. All right, so that's so you see that now. You may want to make it bigger. All right, then the same thing happens on the other side. Okay, so we have this, the top and the bottom reinforcement to span along this span. All right, so to call out these bars will be very simple, just the way we've been doing before now. All right, to call out reinforcements shouldn't be a new thing to everyone who've been watching for the past few videos that I've been releasing. All right, so this should be about 3Y16. Then the bar mark, maybe 01, right? You want to also reduce this one to the dimension that really works. Then we have the same on the other end, all right? And the reason they can be the same is because we're having the same span, the same diameter of reinforcement, all right, and the same shape. So these exactly are the parameters that could warrant, or that would warrant bars for having the same bar marks. Alright, so having this now has really given you your top and bottom reinforcement. Now to show you the shear reinforcement, which is the one we call our links, alright? Alright, our links is supposed to be at an allowance away from the face of your beam or your support end, alright, about 50 mm there, alright, on both sides. So it has to be also thick. It has to be thick between the two bars, alright. Then you have to show the information of that bar that you have here. From here, it starts from here and ends here. So it means that my call out will be here. So to write the information of the link that I have up here, I can just copy this down here. Then what do? I measure the span with which I want to spread my links, 3675, with the known spacing for my design, 3675, for example, divided by 150. I have 24.5, alright, that's about 25, then plus 1, 26. So I have, this is quite different in expressing 26 y 10, for example, 01 at 150 center to center links. See that now? So we have this. This shows the details of my links. The next one is to show this in section. So you may cut your section at any point that you will. Alright, so this and this, I decided to cut my section at that point. Then you can name your section 1-1, whatever it is you want to name it, 1-1. Then you have this. Now let's have this in section 450 by 225. Alright, and because of the slab that we have on one side, remember it's on one side, so you keep it on one side, which is to say the interior part of the structure according to our general arrangement. And the thickness of the slab is 150. Which is monolithic. Alright, so we have something like this. Alright, so to put our reinforcement straight up, we have 25 our cover all around. All around, all right. So this forms my links, all right. So then to make it thicker, I want to change the thickness of the links to make a distinction there. So to have my reinforcement, I said I have three reinforcements as the top reinforcement, so then I'm going to hatch this. So I have this, I have this, and I have this. On the other side also, I have the same thing. Alright, then, this is my links. See that now? Now to to just call out my reinforcement. Yeah, I can just make it a little smaller to something that works. 0-1 to something that really works. Yeah, this is good. This works. So we have 0-1, 0-1, 0-1. The same thing we have on the other side, 0-1, 0-1, 0-1. So you may call out your reinforcement, your links, as you want it. You can, okay, let me put this to something that works too. 0.3. All right, this works. So we have our links according to our detail here. We want to put it to, we have Y10, 0-1. All right, Y10, 0-1, and then you may just want to put your dimensions. Something that works too. Seems to be, alright, this doesn't work anyway. So you have you may want to just put it for, alright, so adjust the offset, whatever it is, just make it work. Then we have this also 2 to 5, just put it down to something that works. All right, so 2 to 5. Then you may want to call out your about that and look for something that works. Yeah, this is quite better. So that is that. You have your links and your main reinforcement, your links, your styros and your main reinforcement. So that's quite good on that. You may want to put the dimension to this. All right, with these 4 meters, let's put something that really. All right, so that is it. If you have any questions that's touching what I've just done, you may do well to use the comment section, and I'll be there to answer to all your queries, your comments, your questions, and all. All right, so if you're new to my channel and you've not followed, you've not subscribed, I like that you use the subscribe button and do that so that on my next and subsequent releases, you'll be receiving it first hand. See you in the next video. Bye.